What do you say to the folks who say, East Harlem can't stand still, you must have some progress?
I think you do need progress, but I think you need progress to the extent that it's inclusive and that everybody will benefit from it. You can't have progress that just benefits one or two groups. It has to be well thought out planning and economic development programs and initiatives that are going to benefit the large number of people in the community, and that take into consideration the people who've been here for 50 years or 60 years, the people who fought through the times when no one wanted to be in East Harlem, when we had a high crime rate, when we had high unemployment, and we had a bunch of empty lots in the community, and nobody wanted to come into East Harlem. There are many people who are still here who endured all of that, mm-hmm. and those people have to be considered, and they have to be nurtured as far as programs and initiatives are concerned.
Because there are some good things going on in East Harlem.
Yes, there are. There are many good things. We have a lot of cultural programs. We have some new businesses that are located in the community. We got our first cafe that located on Lexington Avenue, which was great. And we do have new things like restaurants, for example, that are coming in. And that's great because that builds up, you know, the tourism industry as well. So there are certain segments of the business community which are being rejuvenated right now. And that's great for East Harlem.
What's in the future for Hector Santana?
That remains to be seen. I mean, I'm pushing along, and I'm working on a number of different projects. As I mentioned to you earlier, I'm working on a charter school, which I support. I'm working on some economic development projects. I'm working on some affordable housing projects, which are great. And I'm just very happy to be able to be involved in what's going on. And you know, your first question was, did I think I would ever be involved in this? And the answer was no, not really. and it would be definitely no to the extent that I'm involved now. But I'm very happy to be able to have an impact. And I'm proud of what I've done, some of the work that I've done on East River Plaza when I was at Empire State Development, and even on the Potemkin project on 128th Street. I'm happy to be able to say that I had something to do with things that are going on in East Harlem, with some pretty significant economic development projects. And so that makes me proud. So I think I'm going to continue to do that, and I think that's going to be in my future for quite some time.
Now, you spent 15 years working for the legislature in Albany.
Yes, I did.
Public office in the future?
I wouldn't rule it out. I wouldn't rule out public office.
I've heard that one before. Yeah. Are you leaving the door open, in other words?
I would definitely leave the door open. I mean, I love to be a public servant. And I spent most of my career as a public servant, serving in the Senate and the Assembly in a variety of different capacities. And I love working with the people, and it's something that I enjoy immensely. And I think I'll continue to do that. And so I wouldn't rule out a run for public office in the future. I think it's something that is a possibility.
Hector Santana, Chairman of the East Harlem Chamber of Commerce, thanks for being our guest.
Thank you very much, Fred. Thank you for having me.
This program is brought to you by Digital Laundry, The Fresh Bread Group, Mount Morris Park Dental, and the Creole Restaurant and Music Supper Club.